Hi guys, it's Heather here at the Craft Shack for another This and That Thursday, and today I'm doing something from before Christmas. I had an assignment basically. At my church, we do what we call I call it the snatch and grab party, but it's like white elephant. Everybody brings a gift or whatever, and then we draw numbers, and then you can either steal it or open a new gift. You know how that works, I'm sure. So we did that. We do that every year as a church family, and it's quite fun. And it's become something that they kind of expect me to make stuff for, and maybe they don't necessarily, but that's how I see it. So I had this two, and because Greg and I are both going, of course, that means I have to make two gifts. So I had this idea to make these two canvas panels, and that's what you see here. I had canvas panels, and I'm using Prima's matte medium gel. I think it's a 3D gel. I don't have it handy, so I can't look at it and tell you exactly, but I showed you there at the very beginning. Anyway, it's their gel, and it's quite thick. And I like it because it works really good as a glue. And I was also at the very bottom of the jar, so it was kind of nice to be able to scoop out every last bit. And I took my old hymnal pages and an old Bible that I'm still using up the pages from. And I had actually chosen specific pages about the story of the birth of Christ, and I put those on there. Now this is an old dictionary page. I was very fortunate at the thrift store to find a very old, large dictionary in very good shape, but it was only half of the dictionary. So it's like from one of those sets, and you have like A through L and N through M through K, Z or whatever it is. I don't even know what the letters are that it's through, but basically. It was like 1950s or something. So there I'm telling you, I cut two sets of those three circles. And then I sketched out some branches to use as twigs for arms, but it's very difficult to piece together proportionately what you want. But anyway, so I cut these two sets of branches and snowmen out. And I now am using clear gesso to cover the whole thing because old pages, and especially cheap old pages, have differences to them. And so I didn't want to add color and have the color absorb differently into the different papers. So at this point, I put clear gesso on. Now I intended to use clear gesso one and maybe two more times throughout this project, but I forgot. So this is just some Kraaft paint, and it's a pretty bright blue, as you can see, and I just dry brushed it on. My purpose was to really give it this very kind of a misty look, like how it is on the edges. I really like that. So I had to wipe it back some with a wet baby wipe, and it didn't really respond well because you can see it's real choppy. But once it dried, I was like, oh, okay, maybe I meant to do that. And this, for some reason, this one went on way smoother. So as they're both gessoed, I thought it would more go on like this, and then I could wipe it back. But the other one didn't behave quite that way. And I'm sorry for the lighting. For some reason, my camera decided to go nutso, and I had to actually redo all my camera software because of this. But anyway, so I really wanted to be able to see those pages through all that paint. It didn't quite work out the way I wanted it to. At this point, I really kind of like that, but you're going to see I mess it all up. So my idea is to use some Dylusions sprays and dark colors and some Lindy stamp gang because I wanted the shimmer that those Lindy stamp gang have. And then the spray wouldn't work, so then I dump some on and just use the same paintbrush and kind of smeared it around because I just really wanted some shimmer, but I didn't like the coloring. It was starting to look like water. And this is not an ocean scene I'm going for here, but if I were, this would have worked really well, but see how turquoisey that is? Not what we intended. Okay, well, let's try purple with some brown undertones. No. Right at this moment, I'm going, okay, undo. Where's the undo button? Just dry it. Just dry it and move on. That's what I'm thinking there. And then I like how when you dry it and the drips sort of get thicker and you see the movement. I was liking that and I thought maybe I could use it, but I don't. So then I thought, okay, I'll use the dilution sprays and cover that up and make it darker. Holy cow, did I make it darker? This was not my intention. I was like, well, crap, move on to the second one. So, and whatever I do to the one, I've got to do to the other because they're basically going to be like a matching set, even though I don't expect the people to get them to be, the same family or something. I just really wanted them to be obviously made, obviously a set. I don't know. Whatever. Oh, that coloring is so off. It is not as atrocious as it appears. Okay, here I'm showing you this shimmer. There's some shine in there. You can't really see it that well, but okay, tone this pink down. That's what I'm thinking. And basically, I'm obliterating everything behind it. Like, forget that there are even pages back there now at this point. And as I'm drying it, I'm going, this is not, that pigment is so strong. I really expected it to be more transparent than that. But it's not. Maybe if I use a baby wipe. It's sort of working. Not much. Yeah. This really wasn't what I was going for when I started this whole thing, so I was really kind of frustrated. And basically, when I was saying that I intended to use clear gesso, I was so frustrated by this that I forgot about the gesso from here on forward. So, some mistakes happened that I end up really being in love with in the end, but not throughout the process. So I thought I would tone it down some and add a little bit more of that shimmer. And it, really, tone it down isn't what I mean. I just wanted way more shimmer than what was showing. So I just added that extremely translucent Lindy stamp gang because I just wanted the shimmer. Now you can hopefully see there's bright turquoisey shine in there. It looks like moonlight, sort of. That's my thought. Sure. So now I'm laying out those previously cut snowmen and twigs and realizing proportions now. Huge. Huge snowmen on my tiny little canvases. Yeah. And I actually end up walking away from this for about an hour and a half, just really frustrated with how all the coloring turned out and everything. It's so funny how something in your head looks one way and then practically it's different. So I walk away. I kind of left them sitting there like this, walked away, and came back and went, oh, I could just cut these smaller. And kind of forgot about the coloring problems. So I did the one on the left already as kind of like a test, and you notice the twigs are still huge. I don't like that. So I don't actually show it. I just showed you how I cut the circles down. It was pretty simple. But then I actually trimmed the twigs down too. You just don't see me do that on camera. And now at this point, I'm taking the Dylusions White Linen, which is a pigment ink instead of the transparent inks that I'd already sprayed on there. And I just basically layered, layer dry, layer dry, layer dry. And I was kind of liking what was happening here, but it was much more of an experiment. And right about now, maybe third or fourth spray into here, I go, crap. I was going to gesso this, wasn't I? Yeah, that's right. The clear gesso would have helped because then the white would have stood right off the top of it. But I forgot. And as irritated as I am right now, where I'm realizing that it would have also stopped this bleeding that you're seeing happen, where the white is now turning that pink from underneath. It's basically bleeding up through the white. Well, that would have stopped that if I'd have used the clear gesso. However, I like the end result. So, as irritated as I am that that did not, I forgot that hugely important step. I'm really grateful when you see in the end, because I like how whimsical it looks in the end. But anyway, so this time I said, okay, I'm going to just spray the bottom really good, spray some at the top, give it some air dry, some blow dry there. Then I'm going to go back in with another layer of white, and then I'm going to set it aside and let it dry like that. A little bit of cleanup there. Okay, now at this point, I had done some things off camera, and I apologize for that because there's a couple times where I had lost some footage, and I'm not sure why. But basically, I cut on my Cricut these snowflake shapes, and I used the negative up in the left-hand corner. You can see there I had taken heavy white gesso that I just showed you there from Prima, and I had used that makeup sponge and gone through like a stencil and put it onto the canvas. But when I did that, I didn't really like the results, so I used the stencil that I had cut out and made that white, and then moved over, and you see what I did. So now I've got another piece of that dictionary paper, and I am trying out the words, and I realize they're way too small. I want them to be bigger. So, and I do this sometimes. I'll fill a whole page with the words that I want to use in different handwriting styles or different colors, maybe just different things, and then I'll use the one that I think will work. Or sometimes I'll cut them all out and mix and match, or you just never know. So basically, I'm using the same process for both sets of words, and there I tested best in my cursive handwriting, and I didn't like it. It just sort of blended into the words beneath it. So the whole time I'm writing this, I'm thinking, but how am I going to set those apart? Oh, I know. I'll put dots on the end of all of these letters. And I don't want to do them all, so we'll just do the word best and the word flakes. And I think if I were doing this again, I would have done best friends like that. Then, of course, I cut them out, which you don't need to see that part. But then I used a re-inker, and I think it is vintage photo. Used a re-inker and then realized real quick that I needed to add water and water it down. Duh. And then just did this to all the words of the one cold heart, cold twigs, warm heart. Those were done like that, just like you see. And then the other ones I did differently. I just sort of pounced all the color onto each one. And that was much simpler for one thing, but also the word my there gets really dark. And so I wrote another my and colored it. Oh, and this was dumb. This was so dumb. I started blow drying these things, and as they dried, they flew away. So I ended up losing a couple and had to redo some. So if the words look different, that's why. But so that one first word, my, actually was really dark once it was dry. So I made another one, and you're gonna laugh when you see what I did. So here I am using the same thing I did with the other papers in the first step, was using that 3D matte gel. And all these products are by, well, everything except for Dylusions and the Lindy stamp green sprays, but all the rest of it is Prima products. I just really, and we carry almost everything in the store. I just really wanted to use, I really like using Prima products. I think that they were made for this kind of fun art, and I like how they work. When I use the modeling paste, I think it's light modeling paste, I'm not sure, we'll see in a bit. When I use that, it just makes me so happy, I don't know. And I love how, you know, you have some play time, but not a lot. It's like it sticks down pretty quick, but you can still move it around. You'll see me do that with the snowman here. Okay, so it says some of my, and there's that dark my that I was telling you about. You can't even hardly read it. And then it says my best friends. Yeah, so I ended up using the my that I was trying to redo, and I didn't even realize it. Did not even realize it through this whole process. Oh, you gotta love it. Okay, so I put the twigs on. Yeah, and then I'll show you how you still have some wiggle room, because I'm gonna wiggle it in a second here. So right there I realized, oh no, push it down. And it still was movable at that point. So that's kind of nice. I like that. Now here's where another area where I wish I would have used the gesso, because as you can see in the pictures, as what you're looking at right here is the outline of all the words is darker blue and all that, and that's from that gel. And had I used the gesso before I started gelling everything, wouldn't have had that problem. Oh well. So here I'm using that light molding paste and putting this over, and again the gesso would have helped with this part too, but in the end I kind of like the result. But see how crisp and white those snowflakes are, which is that's that bubbles stencil also by Prima, but so versatile. I love that stencil. But if I were to use the gesso, then those would stay crisp and white, and so would the snow that I am just wiping down at the bottom, which is like a pillowy cloud. I loved that. That was awesome. And just using the palette knife to kind of wipe away where the stuff had gotten. I want those snowflakes to be in the background, and that really helped right there doing that. So that's kind of nice. But as they dry, they will not that will not remain that crisp white. In the end, I like it, but that wasn't what I was intending to do. So now here I'm using my Signo Uniball pen in white, and you see me kind of rub it on my finger a little bit. I do that to start the ball rolling, and then once I do that, it's fine. Just trying to give some definition to those areas where I'd stenciled and it kind of muddied. It wasn't all that great. And then I highlighted some more of the little dots. I wanted it to look like snow was sort of falling in the background. Not as snowstormy as the other one looked. I wanted them to be different. The same, but different. Oh, and here I'm putting some snow on the twigs. It was very easy to do. I still, at this point, I'm laughing looking at this because it says some of my best friends. How did I not see that? Sometimes you just get so focused. And I decided that I wanted to add some details of like the snow kind of piling up on the ball, you know, the snowballs that created the snowman. I like that. I think that really added to it. Such a little thing. And I didn't want to give them faces. I wanted them to look very old-fashioned. I mean, all the snowmen we see around here that kids make do not look like a snowman with a carrot and a top hat and all that kind of thing. So again with the Dylusion spray, only this time I'm using it with my paintbrush and decided to paint in the snow effect. I wanted this one to be a little bit different than the other one, but once I had done this much and it started to dry, I realized something else. I really wanted it to do something else. So I kind of let it dry. Oh, and I flicked more little dots on. That was nice. Still haven't figured out that there's a second my on there. Okay, more detail on the snowflakes that I stenciled that didn't work out quite well, but it, you know, it turned out to be a really nice thing because they look very wispy. I even drew some more in here. We lost some footage, so you're gonna see. It's definitely more detailed when it's finished. Still a lot more. I ended up liking the layers of blue and purples and all that. It just ended up being a lot more. So now I've got another one of my pens, and I'm going to go in there and make sure that those letters stand out. And I did my twice there, and I still didn't get it. And then I realized in doing that B that that was too bold for that word. So I ignored the rest of it. I did the dots, but I ignored the rest of the word, and I'll do the dots on flakes, but I'll ignore the rest of the letters. And then I go in with the finer lined pen and give more definition to those letters, but in a finer line because they just didn't look right with that bold pen. And even after this, I was like, nope, they still don't stand out enough. It was just too dark, just too much dark. So I went in with the silver pen. I ended up regretting that. And again, in the lost footage, I actually go back over it with a black again and use that silver kind of as a thing. And so then I go back now that that's dry and I add the fluffy white snow instead. That's much better. I wanted it to be different than the other one, but I really liked that pillowy soft snow at the bottom of the thing. And then so I don't put my hand in it, I flipped it around. And using some heavy white gesso because the pen just was not doing enough, so I used a fine paintbrush and that heavy white gesso, and that did the trick. Now it's really, the details are popping right off the page. This ended up making me very happy. I only wish that I had a one more large snowflake on the page, but I don't know where it would have went. I'm saying page, and I mean it's a canvas. I end up putting a snowflake down below his left arm down there on the right-hand side of the canvas, but you won't see me do it. Lost footage. So I outlined in the in a light hand of the gesso because I knew that it would blend into the background, and once it dried some, it would pull up some of the background. And still, I'm outlining the mine. I still don't get it. Oh, Heather. And I end up going around it all with black pen and everything. Again, that's in the lost footage. So here you see them both side by side as they were at that moment. And at this point, I lose that footage of those details. So I'll show you here. See, I'd added some crystals and stuff to some of the snowflakes, and some more snowflakes were added. And see how it dried? There's crystals on some of those there, but how it dried, it looks very, oh, I don't know, it's just very dusty almost, and I like it. So I used the Wink of Stella to add some, it's just the clear, just to add some sparkle to the snow, because that's what I love about snow, is that sparkle when the sun hits it and stuff. So I added some of that there, and I did a little bit on this one, and that's pretty much it. Not a lot. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a crafty day. Bye-bye.